Hello YouTubers, this is Rua Korao once again. This is Rua Korao Music Academy and this is Dylan Gwatidzo. I'm here with my friend Chikodzi. And today we are going to launch a new series which is Music Theory for the junior grade 3 to 7 syllabus for ZIMSEC. We had a lot of requests so that we can assist. So we are going to start a series from today. Some of the topics that we are going to talk about are the following. We are going to look at time values. We're going to look at time signatures, the staff and stuff. We are going to talk about major scales, accidentals, key signatures. And we are also going to talk about intervals and scale degrees. We are also going to talk about musical terms and symbols, tonic so far. And we know that a lot of you, the teachers, have got school competitions every year. And some of you do not know how to read. So we are going to talk about that and also teach you to transcribe from staff notation to tonic so far, and I know it will help you also in churches so that you can read. So we are going to dwell on that topic as well, and also we are going to talk about music technology, including softwares like Sibelius, Finel. We can help each other, even Fruit Loops, because we know that you need to know about that. Then we are going to look at instruments again, and a lot of topics related to this syllabus, music elements, and the likes. So basically, these are some of the topics that we are going to do. And if you've got some topics that you want us to help you, just contact the numbers on the screen. So now we move on to today's lesson. So today we are going to talk about time values. In time values, we are talking about mainly the rhythm of songs, the beat. And we know that when music is being played, you also maybe nod your head or stomp your feet or also play to a certain tune. Basically what you are doing, you are tapping to the beat. So the beats can be named, and they can be named as time values. So we are going to do about 5 time values that are in our syllabus. So the first one is the bigger one, which is we use this symbol, and this symbol is this is a semibrief, and a semibrief has got another name, an American pop name, which is called the whole note. The semibrief has got 4 beats, so it is counted like 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't count the beats separately, but the note is longer, equivalent to 4 beats. Now it has got a French time name, which is called ta-a-a-a. So if you are clapping, you clap like this, ta, then you hold on a-a-a. So if it's a note, or if a note that maybe you are singing, it will be like ah. That's how long the semibrief is. So we move on. We've got another, this one, which is a bit smaller, and this is called a minim. Now a minim is half the semibrief. Since the semibrief is called a whole note, now this is a half note. So half of 4 is 2. So it's 2 beats longer. So now the French time note, the French time name of the minim is called ta-a. So you just hold like ta, then you hold with 1 beat. So it's like ah. So that's how long the minimum, and these notes are usually used at the end of songs, the longer notes. For example, you are saying for the Zimbabwe national anthem, you are saying Nyika ye Zimbabwe. That's a longer note that is used on the ending of songs. So that's the minimum and that's the symbol. Now we've got the another note, which is called, we are still on time values, this is called the crotchet, and that's called a quarter note in American pop name, and it's one beat, which is ta. So this is the symbol of the crotchet. That's the, what we call a beat. This is the standard beat that is used in music. So usually music is measured in crotchets. So that's a crotchet now. Okay, so we move on. We've got now the smaller notes that we've got, and this is the first symbol for the smaller notes. Now if you look, it has got a note head and it has got a stem, then also having a flag. This is a flag to the right. So this note is called, this is called a quaver. This is a quaver. I know that many people confuse the quaver with the semi-quaver, but this is called a quaver with one flag. Now a quaver is an eighth note. It's an eighth note, and it is equal to half a beat. This is equal to half a beat. When we are singing Si Moza, we have started with two quavers. Si Moza, so that's a quaver, and a quaver is equivalent to half a beat. And we're saying a crotchet is one beat. So if we beam two quavers, they will sound like tate. So when we are counting one, we clap two times. So maybe if it's a count, like we are saying 1, 2, 3, 4, would say ta te ta te ta te ta te. So that's how we clap on in one beat. We should have clapped two times. So that's a quaver. Now the last note that we are going to discuss in this lesson is the semi quaver. Now the semi quaver looks like this. It has got two flags to the right. So the semi quaver is called a 16th note in American, is an American pop name. Then the French time name is tafatefe. We explain that the value of a quaver, semi quaver, is a quarter beat. Now so the French time name tafatefe is when we beam four quavers together. So when we beat on one count like this, one, we count we need to be clapping four times on one count like this, tafatefe. We don't say tafatefe. Why? Because it will be four beats. So if we are saying 1, 2, 3, 4, we are saying tafatefe, 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 tafatefe. So this is got a value of a quarter beat. So we explain on other songs. So this is our lesson today. This is about time values. Thank you.